All right, class, don't forget, your 25-page research paper is due tomorrow before class. Have a good rest of your day.
Oh, I forgot about this.
Joe's gonna freak out when he hears this.
Dude, I totally forgot that the paper was due. Dude, we're so screwed, man. I don't even know what I'm gonna research.
Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get that done.
I mean, we're gonna have to get it done. It's like 500 points. That's about half our grade.
All right, well, how about everyone come to my house later? All right, we'll get it done. What's up, guys?
What's up, dude? All right, let's get this paper done, bitches.
Yeah, I'm trying to get this done quick so I can go home. Still have time to play four.
Did you guys bring Jack with you?
No, I haven't heard from him since we left school. All right, I'm bored.
Yeah, me too. Let's take a video game break.
Whoa. We just started, guys. We can't take a break yet.
Well, I mean, don't worry. We can just play for like 30 minutes.
Seven p.m. Are you kidding me? That's 2 hours. You said we played for 30 minutes.
Well, relax, man. It's only 7 p.m. We've got all night still.
Yo, I got like 30 texts from Jack saying that his car's dead and he's on the side of the road.
Well, we gotta go get him. You can't just leave him there on his own.
We don't have time. We haven't even started yet.
Well, I know if it was me, I'd want us to pick me up.
Fine, let's go.
All right.
Are we close yet? We've been driving forever.
He shouldn't be too far now.
I'm gonna call him. Hey man, I think we're close. Where exactly are you?
Yeah, I'm on the side of the road. I can see you. I can see your headlights now.
Okay. Alright. Got it. We'll be there soon. He said he's just up the road. He sees our headlights. Yo, dude, you look a little rough.
Thanks, man. It's freezing out here, bro. I'm tired.
Where's your car?
The tow truck already grabbed it. Can you just unlock the car, please?
All right.
So what happened? How did your car break down?
It's the weirdest thing, bro. I'm telling you. I was just driving to your house, and I saw this raccoon. It ran out right in the middle of the road, right in front of my car.
Did you hit it?
No, I swerved out of the way. Slammed on the brakes and all that, but that's when my engines just started making these crazy sounds in my car. It just wouldn't drive, like, at all.
Well, at least you're out of the cold. Let's get back and start writing our papers.
About that, my computer's at home. Now we're gonna have to stop by my house to get it.
Are you serious? It's already 7:30. We haven't even started yet. It's due tomorrow morning.
I know. I'm sorry. I need my computer. I gotta do it. I gotta do my paper. I'm sorry.
I guess. Fine. Let's go. Come on.
Damn it.
I mean, I think the Bears still have a chance to make playoffs this year.
Stop. No way, bro. I don't want to stand out here in the cold and hear you fantasize about how if 50 different things go right, the Bears might make a playoff game.
Dude. Like I was saying, if we get like five,
bro, would you
wins
shut up
season
about the Bears? It's over. All right? It's over.
Joe, you mind telling me where the car is?
Yeah, Jonah, it's right over there.
definitely not right where you left it.
What are you talking about, Jonah? It's dude. Right over... Oh, no.
Oh, no? What do you mean, oh, no? Where the f*** is the car?
It was right there, I swear.
What are we gonna do now? My computer's in there.
Dude, mine too.
Dude, you guys are worried about your f- computers. I just lost my f- car.
No. I'm sorry, Joe, but there's bigger problems now.
Relax, chill, all right?
Dude, my car is gone.
Sorry, man.
Yeah, that sucks.
I'm sorry, too.
I just paid it off.
All right, let's start walking. Cause you had a bad day, you're taking one down. You sing a sad song just to turn it around. You say you don't know, you tell me don't lie. You work on a smile and you go for a ride. You had a bad day, the camera don't lie. You're coming back down and you really don't mind. You had a bad day, you had a bad day.
That was my lifeguard training.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah.
Sorry for getting angry at you guys earlier.
Hey, it's all right, man. At least we're back inside now.
Yeah, it's all right. I could probably get a new car from insurance or something.
It's such a hassle, man. Do you even know how to file a report?
No, but I'll probably just use ChatGPT or something and figure it out.
Joe, you're a genius.
I am?
That's how we get the papers done. We'll use ChatGPT. We'll do it on Jack's computer and we'll be done in no time.
Dude, you're right. We could get this done.
All right. We are so back.
Let me finish my lifeguard training first.
Nope. Everybody wants a new romance. Everybody's going off the deep end. Everybody needs a second.
Thank God this is over. Now, I know some of you guys have heard about our new academic dishonesty policy. So we have a new software that can detect when you use things like ChatGPT and AI. So let's make sure we're being honest with each other, okay?
Oh, sh**. So screwed, man.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm going to research. You
fucking 30 texts from Jack saying that his car is dead and he's on the side of the road.
Yeah. Hey, man. I think we're close. What exactly are you? Oh, dude. You look a little rough.
Thanks, man. I'm trying to freeze out here, bro. It's cold.
Dude, you don't look
where's your car?
Did you hit it?
No, I swerved, but like, oh, what was going on?
Yo, Derek!
What up, Jesse?
Orange juice?
Yes, sir.
What you got there, man?
Hey, just looking over some pictures I took for this class project.
You took these shots, man?
Yes, sir.
Okay, those are pretty nice, man.
Hey, appreciate it, man. Appreciate it. You know, I'm working real hard for this class. Sure.
Hey, man, we can't spend all day looking at these shots, man. We gotta go to class, bro.
Oh, I forgot about that. Oh, I hate these 8 a.m.s.
Hey, man, you coming to that party tonight?
Nah, we got tryouts tomorrow.
Bro, you know Bella gonna be there now.
For real? I guess I'll go.
Yes, sir. Let's get it, man.
This though.
No.
No! Saw what you did out there, Jesse. How would you love a spot on the basketball team?
I love it, coach. I make your team the greatest team in the nation.
What do you want?
I'm just here for our headshots. Derek? Are you okay?
Yeah, why wouldn't I be?
I heard about the game.
It wasn't a game. It was a tryout. I don't even know why I'm wasting my time talking to you. You wouldn't understand.
Well, if that's how you feel about me.
Bella, wait. Go out with me.
Derek, I have a boyfriend.
It's always a boyfriend. It's always some other dude, man. You're gonna tell me I'm just not good enough.
This is so ridiculous. You know what? I'm leaving.
You know what? Leave. I don't want you in here anyways. You know what?
grandma's famous Italian cookies. Now,
the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.
I thought this would be a nice way to remember her by, because if you knew my grandmother, you knew she started cooking Christmas cookies in October.
I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more.
She just made so many of them, and she loved so many people, and she was a good person, and she just wanted to spread her love with cookies. So we are reinventing the cookie today, or trying to reinvent the cookie.
I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did.
So we have the anise cookies, which is an acquired taste, but for whatever reason, being in the Italian family, you like the black licorice taste, but I think most of us don't like it by themselves, but we liked it in grandma's anise cookies. So we're making anise, and we're also making the chocolate. She makes little chocolate ball cookies, but there's a lot of other spices that go into it that are not chocolate, and so it's like a spice chocolate cookie.
Much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew.
Grandma just had a huge heart, and her family was her life, and that was just, it's just evident when you walk in the house, there's pictures of us all over the place. And one of the ways that she showed love was with her cookies, and I thought that that would be a good way not only to honor her, but for all of us to get together and do something more that we've not all done together before. So they're probably not going to be exactly the same, because I don't think that anybody can bake like grandma, but yeah, grandma's cookies were the bomb.
Love, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill.
How are you feeling?
I'm okay.
You're okay? Good.
Hola, me llamo Paola, tengo 20 años y soy de Venezuela. Que en medio de Venezuela era feliz, normal, pero habían ciertas circunstancias que nos hicieron tomar la decisión, a mis padres y a mí, de que lo mejor era buscar un mejor futuro en otro país. Las razones principales por las que decidimos que era hora de irnos de Venezuela era porque Venezuela está pasando por una situación muy difícil, en la que hay mucha inflación económica, mucha corrupción por parte del gobierno, mucha inseguridad, y ya estar en Venezuela no era vida para las personas que están allá. Llevo 3 meses en este país. Se me ha hecho increíble, pero al mismo tiempo se me ha hecho difícil acostumbrarme y adaptarme a la cultura, al idioma sobre todo, a las nuevas normas que en mi país no habían para nada.
¡Ay, Dios mío! Me siento una niña. ¡Amiga, mira este!
¿Qué extrañas de tu país? ¿Qué extrañas de Venezuela?
Bueno, de mi país Venezuela extraño la comodidad que tenía allá y extraño a mi familia. En los momentos difíciles también, algo que me ayuda a mantenerme positiva es recordar que si logré pasar y superar un momento difícil en mi vida, que fue cuando me operaron de la columna y estuve un poco mal de salud, voy a poder con todo. Y que si la Paola de ese momento pudo, la de ahorita también, y con 1000 cosas más. Y que siempre va a poder, porque siempre podemos. Cuando llegué a este país me di cuenta de que muchas personas creen que es más fácil de lo que parece. Creen que simplemente llegas y muy rápido ya tienes mucho dinero y tienes la vida perfecta, pero la verdad es que no es así. Hay mucho trabajo detrás de eso y mucho esfuerzo. Y cuando siento que me voy a rendir y que ya no doy más, me acuerdo de que no existe el éxito sin el fracaso y que siempre vuelve a salir el sol y que lo que fácil viene, fácil se va, como dice el dicho. Lo que le diría a alguien que esté pasando por la misma situación de dejar su país y venir a otro nuevo es que no se rinda, aunque suene cliché quizá, que no se rinda, porque esos momentos difíciles son los que la van a ayudar a madurar, a crecer y a hacerse fuerte, y que en un futuro ella pueda, con todos esos conocimientos, ayudar a otras personas. A veces nosotros los seres humanos cometemos el error de pensar que la vida se basa en solo felicidad y que si no eres feliz el 100% de tu tiempo, no eres feliz. Pero en verdad, yo considero que la vida se basa en que no existe tristeza sin alegrías y no existe alegrías sin tristeza. Entonces todo es un balance y que hay que tener de todo en la vida para poder sentir al máximo, porque así es que se vive.